In this bulletin, Israel's military kills 356 people in Lebanon as cross-border attacks intensify. The Reserve Bank said to keep interest rates on hold for another month, despite the cost of living crisis. And in the AFL, Carlton captain Patrick Cripps wins the Brownlow medal. With the latest SBS News, I'm Biwa Kwan. Lebanon says at least 365 people have been killed in Israeli strikes on the south, marking Lebanon's highest daily death toll in over a year of Israeli attacks on its borders. The Lebanese Health Ministry says women, children and emergency workers are among those killed by Israel. Officials said around 80,000 attempted calls were made to civilians in Lebanon on Monday, threatening the looming attacks and ordering evacuations. In a televised statement, Israel's military spokesman, Rear Admiral Daniel Hagari, issued a similar warning.
We ask residents of Lebanese villages to pay attention to the message and warning published by the IDF and heed them. This is an advance warning for your own safety and the safety of your family. We advise civilians from Lebanese villages located in and next to buildings and areas used by Hezbollah for military purpose, such as those used to store weapons, to immediately move out of harm's way for their own safety.
Meanwhile, Hezbollah has launched dozens of strikes at Israeli targets in retaliation for the Israeli strikes. With escalations stretching beyond the border between Israel and Lebanon, concerns of an all-out regional war continue mounting. The federal government says Peter Dutton's speech on the coalition's nuclear power plan shows he does not have a well-thought-out energy policy. Speaking at a Committee for Economic Development of Australia function, Mr. Dutton delivered sharp criticism of the current government's renewable-focused energy policy. The speech, however, gave no further detail on the cost of the nuclear power plan. Climate Change Minister Chris Bowen says Mr. Dutton has once again failed to provide Australians with answers.
Peter Dutton had an opportunity today, indeed an obligation, in his big speech about nuclear energy to provide the Australian people with costings, with facts, with modelling and with details about his nuclear scheme. He failed on every single metric. What we saw today was more of the same. More rhetoric, more misleading statements, more basic facts wrong, and a speech which raises more questions than it answers yet again.
The Minister for Indigenous Australians, Melandiri McCarthy, has called the opposition leader's plan to axe the First Nations ambassador disappointing. The role is a focus on supporting First Nations trade by embedding Indigenous perspectives into foreign policy and improving ties with communities in the Indo-Pacific region. That's after News Corp papers reported the government spent more than $145,000 on the ambassador's travel last financial year. Ms. McCarthy has defended the role.
It's important that people representing Australia, whether it's through ambassadors who reflect the needs of Australians and Australian businesses, or whether it's diplomats who travel, naturally there will be a cost to that travel. In the case of Ambassador Mohammed, his work is important to connect with countries not just far away, but also here in the Pacific, with Fiji, Vanuatu, Tuvalu.
Goring Goring man Justin Mohammed was appointed Australia's inaugural First Nations ambassador last year. The Reserve Bank is expected to keep interest rates on hold for another month, despite the high cost of living. The interest rate is at 4.35%, while inflation was at 3.5% for the month of July. Last week, the US Central Bank cut its benchmark rate for the first time in more than 4 years. RBA Governor Michelle Bullock has ruled out any interest rate cut this year. Most economists don't expect a rate reduction until next year. And to sports. In the AFL, Carlton player Patrick Cripps has won the prestigious Brownlow Medal, collecting 45 votes throughout the 2024 season. The Brownlow Medal awards the player deemed best and fairest throughout the AFL season and is determined by votes cast by the four officiating umpires after every game. Collingwood star Nick Dacos was tipped to win after polling in 14 matches and winning 3 best on grounds. Swans player Isaac Heaney also had a promising start to the vote with 5 best on grounds this season, but was ineligible after a 1-game ban in July. And that's the latest from the SBS Newsroom.